This is where both the cars feel very familiar. Both are based on the same platform, and there are a lot of common components inside, down to the switchgear and other controls.
Although the layout of both the dash is quite similar, there's a difference in their treatment. The Superb gets a lot more flash. It has a two-tone beige and black theme, and there's a lot of glossy wood, glossy black, and shiny chrome in the cabin. It's a little too ostentatious for my taste. I prefer the all-black look of the new Passat. The center console is finished very nicely in brushed steel effect, while there's one single veneer of wood that gives it a great feel. Then there's an analog clock. But what I like the most is the steering mounted buttons that control the radio, your telephone, and other functions. It's the best layout that I've used so far in a car. It's much better to use than the Superbs, where you have to press it much harder.
Both cars get similar touchscreen multimedia systems with exactly the same functionality, but it feels much better on the Passat, which has a nicer color scheme and better fonts. The Superb system seems to belong to the 80s video game era. With all the glossy wood and black finish all around, it feels rich and will please everybody. The Passat's all-black interiors with lots of brushed steel effect in the flowing center console, however, win my vote for being a little sporty. Where Superb excels is in terms of nicer seats. The front seats are a bit too sporty for the car and come with extended side support, which keep you in place. The Passat 2 has comfortable seats at the front with perforated leather and cooling or heating function, so you can say goodbye to sweaty backs.
Well, this, as you can see, is Superb's USP. Well, if you want to be chauffeured around all day long and never want to get behind the wheel, this is the car to buy if you don't want to spend on an S-Class. Well, the Passat is also reasonably spacious, but not as roomy as the Superb.
The Superb also comes up a bit more practical owing to its boot. Although the Passat's isn't small either, the Superb's rear hatch door makes it easier to store bigger luggage. But there's nothing that beats the Passat Highline's park assist. Call it a party trick, but it comes in really handy in this age of parking space crunches. Just spot a parking spot, parallel or perpendicular, activate the park assist and drive past it. Then, let the car steer automatically as you feather the throttle. Simply brilliant.